What's up, taters? This is Tree from treeoflogic.com. Now, before I begin, this video will not be monetized because this type of topic is foreboding. But those of you who attended my live stream last night, you all know how I felt about this. I read about 90% of the article, and I gave you my full opinion on it. If you would like to watch that, it's available on my website right now. Okay, just go to treeoflogic.com and you can join my membership site to see this. So a lot of my videos, actually I would have to say 99% of the videos I do on Monday and Thursday on the live streams are available here, because of pretty sensitive topics that are, I don't want to violate YouTube's terms of service. And as always, whenever I personally demonetize or take the monetization off of a video and you all want to incentivize me to keep this going, links are available in the description box below as well as the pinned comment. It is not mandatory, or I'm not telling you you have to. It's just if you want to, and if you're generous, you can. And I will continue to do videos like this that will not get monetized because this is my job. Though, although this will not be monetized, it's still something that you need to be informed about. So let's get started. So this was a very mind-blowing article. Women inmates condemn California for pro-trans laws, forcing them to be housed with abused by men. State hands out condoms and pregnancy resources. Now, this title doesn't even do the article justice. However, I just want to bring you back down memory lane, because this is not something that has like just started to happen. It started to happen in England first. So this is in America, right? The High Court for England and Wales rejected challenge of former inmate who claims she was sexually assaulted by trans prisoners. So this started in the UK first. I would have to say the UK is the test to see what they can bring in to America. So they started doing this, started putting people like this into women's prisons. And of course, it resulted in things like this. And it's a huge problem. Now, you never, of course, we understand, we never hear this on the opposite end. You never hear men complaining about their sports being infiltrated. You never hear about men complaining about, you know, I mean, oh my God, it's so hard to talk fair, but you never hear men, biological men, complain about trans men. You never hear that, okay? It's always the other end. And of course, once this started to happen in the UK, then guess what? Boom, it started to happen in America. This was last year, last February, and this happened in Illinois. So now they're bringing it to California, and I expect to see this happen in every blue city. So there's that. I'm going to just read the article. I'm not going to give my opinion too much. I'm just going to read the article, but I will say this. Feminism has brought women to this place. Now, that's all I got to say. Women locked up in California's largest women's prison are up in arms following the introduction of new pregnancy resources and contraceptives that they say reveals the problem with the state's decision to let biological males to be housed in women's facilities, according to the report from the Christian Post, citing a post from the Women's Liberation Front. WOLF, a left-wing feminist organization, said Thursday that officials at the Central California Women's Facility began providing the new resources, including condoms, after the state began implementing a new law allowing male prisoners who identify as female to be transferred to the women's prison. Since the new law, SB 132, went into effect January, the state has received nearly 300 requests for transfer. Let me just say this again. 300 requests for transfer. All but six of them asked to be moved to a women's facility, and none of the requests has been denied. The Los Angeles Times reported about 20 of the requests have been processed so far, the women's advocacy group said. According to the WOLF, new resources including never-before-needed condoms. I wonder why that is. What do you think? From the state are nothing less than a tactic admission by officials that women should expect to be raped when housed in prison with men, which an inmate described to the group as a nightmare's worst nightmare. One inmate at CCWF told the Times that prison guards have warned them to expect sexual violence. That if we think it's bad now, be prepared for the worst. That it's going to be off the hook. It's going to be jumping. That's what Tamikia Johnson, who's 41 years old, told the Times. They say we're going to need a facility that's going to be like a maternity ward. They say we're going to have inmate programs where inmates become nannies. The fact that all sex is deemed illegal in California prisons make the newly revealed resources an apparent contradiction. More from the WOLF about the newly posted resources. And let's look at this clearly. New posters recently appeared in medical rooms outlining the option available to pregnant people. Now you understand there's a reason why they said pregnant people and not available to pregnant women. Okay, there's a reason why they use pregnant people and not pregnant women. So congratulations, ladies, your feminism is now going to work in reverse to where females are going to be eliminated out of existence. Okay, so let me just read that again. The option available to pregnant people in prison, including prenatal care, abortion, and adoption. The poster also declares that women have the right to contraceptive counseling and your choice of birth control methods by a licensed healthcare provider within 60 to 180 days prior to scheduled release. However, the only methods available to incarcerated women to prevent pregnancy are condoms, which appeared shortly after the men and Plan B emergency contraceptives. And those of you who don't know, Plan B is actually a contraceptives to prevent pregnancy. It has a, I think it has an over a 90% success rate. So if you had unprotected sex, or you were violated in any kind of way and you want to prevent pregnancy, you can go to the pharmacy or a women's clinic and you can get a Plan B pill. All right, so let's finish this. The organization also said that multiple Californian women's prisons are increasing security measures in preparation for potentially hundreds of new dangerous and violent men living alongside the vulnerable inmate population. WOFF reported that one woman made a plea for help during a recent CCWF event. Quote, how do we feel safe in our community? When we reach out for help, we get nothing, the woman reportedly said. There has been an assault on a woman and we still are silenced. She continues, does anyone care that we are being forced to house with 6'2", 250-pound plus men with penises that are here for brutally raping women? She continued, WOLF said, we have been warned by the officials in this prison. More are coming with worse charges. Where is the safety concern for us? If we say we are in fear, we are the ones locked up. And I think what she's talking about is that if she is in fear, they will put her in solitary confinement to protect her from the population. And therefore, that is seen as a punishment, because when inmates are put in solitary confinement, that is a form of punishment, even though some are put in solitary confinement to protect them from dangerous elements within inside the prison. All right, so here we go. Another female inmate told WOLF, "You might as well declare the prison is co-ed and ship us off to Pelican Bay." The California Department of Corrections and Rehabilitation claimed the possibility of pregnancy was considered in the development of SB 132 and that it had procedures in place related to pregnancy, including the fact that sexual acts are already prohibited in prison and are subject to disciplinary actions, but two women can get each other pregnant. That is the most amazing thing about this whole, there's no such thing as gender. There's no such thing as sex and gender is all a social construct. Two women can scissor each other and nothing's gonna happen. Two men can peg each other and nothing's gonna happen. You can't make babies that way. But when you put a biological woman with a biological man, okay, that's when things can happen. The pregnancy is possible during those circumstances, but it is under zero circumstances, zero, that a biological woman can impregnate another biological woman. And the same goes with two biological men. That's the thing. So right now, this entire law about SB 132 is just showing you that, yep, gender is real. Sex is real. I mean, they really show you what's happening. But anyway, let me stop giving my opinion, because, you know, I don't want to go into the forbidden area of YouTube's TOS. Okay, so let me finish the article. It's almost finished. Yet after the biological males began being transferred into the CCWF, the prison began providing condoms to the inmates. In a piece from the Santa Monica Observer, Amber Jackson, an inmate at CCWF, revealed that multiple trans women transferred to the prison still had penises and were HIV positive. The biological males, Jackson said, were abusing and having sex with many of the female inmates. This, according to Jackson, led to the prison's new condom policy. In subsequent item for the Observer, Jackson wrote that the women at the prison are now prey for men. Call yourself a woman all you want, Jackson said, but when you have men with a penis that works as it was designed to do, that's a problem in a women's prison group shower room. That's a problem. So, there you have it. Like I said, I really talked about this in detail in my live stream last night. I'm not going to go into that on this video, because this video is going to stay up on my channel. So there's that. But let me know what you think by leaving a comment below. Also, be sure to like this video and share this video with other women, especially your feminist liberal friends, if you have any. I don't have any female liberal friends. I don't have any feminist friends. But if you do, share this article with them and see what they think. This is Tree from treeoflogic.com. Thank you so much for liking this video and joining my subscriber base. If you haven't subscribed already, please be sure to do so. And I will see you next time. Later, taters.